小朋友们早上好，我是慧娟老师。今天我们又回到线上来上主日学。小朋友们，你们知道为什么吗？为什么我们不能回到礼拜堂去上主日学呢？是的，因为 COVID-19 的病毒又在市面上开始传播开来。为了大家的安全，我们都必须留在家里。小朋友们，如果你们出门回到家的时候，要记得做什么事呢？是的，我们要先洗手，洗洗脚，保持我们个人的卫生。好，小朋友们，我们现在开始做一个开始的祷告。小朋友们，请你们闭上你们的双眼，合拢你们的双手。我们要低头祷告。 Children, let's have an opening prayer. Children, please close your eyes, put your hands together, let's pray. 亲爱的父神，我们今天早上又要来朝见你。我们感谢你过去一个礼拜带领我们平安的度过。今天我们恳求天父你继续保守看顾我们新加坡每一个人，在这个病毒的传播下，让我们那些被染病的有很好的医药照顾，也恳求你是健康，是智慧，给医生护士有能力有体力去照顾这些病人，也恳求你保守我们的爸爸妈妈，保守我们出外上班，出外上课，都能够平安健康。我们将我们今天的崇拜交托在你手里，求你的圣灵与我们同在，接受我们的赞美，接受我们的敬拜。将祷告是奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名，阿们。好，小朋友们，现在让我们用我们的歌声来赞美我们的神。 Let's sing praise to our God.
Jesus, when the sun goes down. shame. Rising again, I bless your name. You are my all in all. And when I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all.
小朋友们，你们做过梦吗？你做过什么梦呢？很可怕的梦，还是很甜美的梦呢？今天我们要跟你说一个故事，一个法老王，他也做梦了。可是他的梦是什么呢？来，让我们一起来看。
2 years later, Pharaoh,The king of Egypt had a dream. In his dream, he was standing beside the Nile River and saw 7 healthy, fat cows grazing in the grass. Then 7 skinny, ugly cows came up out of the Nile and ate the healthy, fat cows. The dream was so real that Pharaoh woke up quickly. He later fell back to sleep.And had a second dream. In this dream, 7 heads of grain that were healthy and good were growing on one stalk. Then 7 heads of thin and scorched grain sprouted up and swallowed the 7 healthy and good heads of grain. As soon as the second dream ended, Pharaoh woke up. He couldn't go back to sleep because he realized the dreams were important and had great meaning.The next day, Pharaoh's mind was troubled. He searched and searched, but no one could tell him the meaning of his dreams. the chief cupbearer noticed, the king was troubled over the meaning of his dreams, and he remembered being in prison and how God used Joseph to interpret his dream. When the cupbearer told Pharaoh about Joseph, he quickly sent for him. After Joseph bathed and changed his clothes, he appeared before the king. Pharaoh said to Joseph, "I had two dreams last night, but no one can interpret them for me. I was told that you interpret dreams." Joseph replied, "I cannot interpret dreams, but God can. Tell me your dreams and God will give you the answer." So Pharaoh told Joseph the two dreams. Joseph said, "Both your dreams mean the same thing. This is very important because it means that God is showing you what he's about to do. In your dreams, you saw seven healthy fat cows come up from the Nile River and seven healthy and strong heads of grain growing on one stalk. These two dreams mean the same thing. For 7 years, God will bring a great abundance of crops and grain. It will be so great that you won't even be able to measure it. You also dreamed that seven skinny and ugly cows ate the seven healthy fat cows, and seven thin and scorched heads of grain swallowed up the healthy and good heads of grain. This means that after the first 7 years of abundance of crops and grain, there will be 7 years of famine. The famine will ravage the land so badly that you will not be able to remember the 7 years of good and abundant crops. The famine will be so severe that nothing will grow." After Joseph finished interpreting the dreams, Pharaoh was stunned. Joseph said to Pharaoh, "Look for a wise man to put in charge over all the land and appoint overseers to be in charge over the crops. During the good years, the overseer should take a portion of the crops and store them to be used during the years of famine." Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Since God has revealed this to you, there is no one as wise as you in all the land." So Pharaoh placed Joseph above everyone in the land, and he was second only to Pharaoh. Joseph remembered all of the sad and painful events he had endured, how his brothers sold him into slavery, and then being thrown in prison for something he didn't do. He had gone from being a slave and a prisoner to being the second highest in the land. Joseph never stopped loving and serving God. He saw that through some of the most difficult times in his life, God was always faithful in fulfilling his plan for his life.
法老王的梦是不是很奇怪呢？他很烦恼，他要知道这个梦到底他的意思是什么。好，很多人都不能够帮他解梦，结果谁帮他解梦呢？是的，是 Joseph。 当 Joseph 帮法老王解了梦以后，法老王夸他说，你好聪明啊。可是 Joseph 他并没有骄傲，他跟法老王说，不是我聪明，是我的父上帝给我的聪明智慧。这个法老王他看到 Joseph 这么聪明，而且他很敬畏他的上帝，他觉得 Joseph 是一个可以重用的人，所以呢，他就让 Joseph 帮助他管理他的国家。我们是不是也能够像 Joseph 一样，无论在怎么样的环境里面，我们都能够尊上帝为大，听上帝的话，祷告， 相信上帝一定能够帮助我们呢？如果以后我们有机会当了医生，我们当了警察或者是老师，我们是不是能够在我们的工作的地范围里面帮助那些有需要帮助的人呢？上帝爱我们，他也希望我们把他的爱分享给我们周围的人。就好像现在这个 COVID， 很多人没有工作，很多人可能就得了这个病。虽然你们年纪还小，没有办法帮助他们，可是小朋友们，你们可以做一件事，就是祷告，求上帝感动很多人来帮助这些需要帮助的人。Today, our Bible verses is the Psalm chapter 33, verse 20. We put our hope in the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Children, let's read together. 1, 2, 3. We put our hope in the Lord. He is our help and our Psalm chapter 33, verse 20. One more time, please. We put our hope in the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Psalm chapter 33, verse 20. One more time. We put our hope in the Lord. He is our help and our shield. Psalm chapter 33, verse 20. Okay, children, let's revise our the Lord's Prayer. Children, do you still remember? Let's read together, okay? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Matthew chapter 6, 9 to 13. 好，让我们来做一个基础的祷告。小朋友们，闭上你们的双眼，合拢你们的双手。我们低头祷告。Let's have a closing prayer. Children, close your eyes, put your hands together. Let's pray.亲爱的天父，我们恳求你帮助我们，让我们有一颗爱人的心，如同你爱我们一样。让我们从小的时候，我们就常常会想到帮助我们周围的人，把你的爱也分享到他们当中去。我们将祷告祈求，是奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名。阿们。好，小朋友，我们下个星期见。愿神看顾保守你们。May God bless you. See you next week. Bye.